Now, where is Larry, our octopus? How do our model and our view connect to each other? Well, let's think about what things happen in our app, and maybe we can sort this out. So first of all, the app loads up. We start with a blank screen. First, the list gets created. Then the list view populates with cats. Larry the octopus does both of these things. Now, not for rendering it on the screen. That's the job of this particular view. But our octopus is what tells this view to render itself in the first place. In other words, the octopus gets things going. Then the octopus changes the current cat in our model. Current cat gets set to this first cat. When that happens, the octopus says, hey, go ahead and render this view here. And then the current cat view gets rendered. Now again, the rendering of this view here is not the responsibility of Larry, but Larry the octopus does tell that view when to render. So now the octopus has gotten our model started, gotten our views started, and everything has gotten rendered. Now let's talk about the case where the user clicks on a cat. Well, the octopus is keeping track of where you click. So if you click on this cat here, the octopus will run a method which increases this counter, first in the model and then in the view. Now, if a user clicks on a cat up here, let's say on this second one here, then the octopus does the following things. First, it changes the model. The current cat is now being set to purr. And then it tells the view over here to re-render itself. So to recount, when the app loads up, first Larry initializes the model. Now in this case, we just have simple data, so that doesn't mean very much. Then Larry tells all of the views to render themselves. And finally, our octopus says, whenever you click on any of these things, do this particular or that particular piece of functionality, and then tell the respective views that have changed to re-render themselves.